Hi, let us understand about Docker service update and rollback. After creating the service, I can go ahead and update the options that I had provided while creating the service, or I can go ahead and add more options to the service. At the same time, I can go ahead and do the rollback if the update is not successful or if I am not satisfied with the update. Let us see an example. Before that, let's go ahead and create a service. Let me list the services available. Docker service ls. I have only one service. Now I am going to create a new service with the name myservice3 with the replica as 2, and I will be using the Nginx version 1.16. Docker service create, and the name of the service I wanted to use replica 2, and the port publishing details I will provide, and I will use the version Nginx 1.16. Two tasks for this particular version of Nginx will get deployed. Now I can get the details about this particular service using the option service ps. So I do have two images with the version 1.16, and it got deployed into these two different hosts. Now let me go ahead and update the image. Docker service update with the image Nginx 1.17 and the name of the service myservice3. So what it will do, it's going to shut down the earlier task with the version 1.16, and it will deploy the new task with the version 1.17. Now I can go ahead and check the details about this particular service. Here I do have the service 1.17, which is in the running state, and the 1.16, the earlier state, it's shut down. And the report, if it is difficult to read, I can go ahead and select only the columns that I wanted to see using the format option. Within the help of Docker, we do have the information about the formats. For example, within Docker service PS, I do have the details about what are all the fields with which I can do the format, and these are all the placeholder names, and I can do the filtering as well using these filters. Let us see a small example. Say I'm going to see the details about the service with ID, name, image, desired state, and current state. This will be much better to read, as well as it will be more formatted so that I can pipe this particular output to some other monitoring tool or some other script. And in case if I wanted to do the filtering based on the state, like for example desired state, I can go ahead and do the filtering as well, where I will see the details about this particular service with ID, name, image, desired state, and current state, and I will apply the filter with desired state equal to running. So only the tasks which are running will get listed. Now, for some reason, if this particular version is not acceptable or it's not up to the expectation, I can go ahead and do the rollback as well. Say these are all the details available. I do have version 2, and what is the image? All the details I do have within the inspect option. Now let me go ahead and rollback. Docker service rollback myservice3. It's as simple as that. So automatically it will get rolled back to the earlier version. Now I can go ahead and do the option of filtering. So it got rolled back to the earlier version 1.16. So we have seen how to do the update of any service, as well as roll back the changes of any service, and how to see the details of a particular service using the filter as well as the format option.